Hi, it's Carby McAvoy. I'm talking about counting the ordering of objects. In other words, the fundamental counting rule, combinations, and permutations. It'll take me a couple of videos to get through all of that. In this first one, we're talking about the fundamental counting rule. And then that just says if there are two events which occur in X and Y ways, then together the events occur in X time Y ways. In a retirement community, here's my example for you. In a retirement community, each resident has a four-character identification sequence. The first place is the letter of the alphabet. That's the first letter of their last name. The second place is a number from 3 to 9, depending on what building they live in. The third is either 1 or 2, indicating 1 or 2 bedroom unit. And the fourth is a number from 1 to 5, depending on the level of care that they receive. How many different IDs can be generated using this method? Well, we're just going to take each of those and multiply those together, because that's what the fundamental counting principle says. There are 26 letters in an alphabet, so we're going to multiply that first place. There's 26 possibilities. There's 7 different buildings, 3 through 9, so we'll multiply that by 7. There are 2 different apartment sizes, 1 or 2 bedroom, so that's 2. And then there are 5 different levels of care, 1 through 5. So we multiply those together and we find out that there's 1,820 different ways that they can give a number out. So if you think about phone numbers, used to be you just would have the 7-digit number, right? And then they started saying, well, we need to put an area code on that. They had to create new area codes because so many more people have phones now. Like everybody pretty much has a phone, and some people have a landline plus a cell phone. And so they need more and more numbers, because as you get more and more people wanting phone numbers, you need more digits to make new numbers for everybody. So that's an example of the fundamental counting rule. I also want to show you the factorial symbol. And I did a video explaining how to use the TI 36X Pro to do factorials and combinations and permutations. So be sure and watch that if you have a TI 36X Pro. If you have any other kind of calculator, just go on to Google and enter in the type of calculator that you have and what you want to learn how to do on it, and there'll be a video there for you. The factorial symbol is exclamation point, says to find the product of the given number and all whole numbers below it, stopping at 1. For example, 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is 120. 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1, which is 6. And 0 factorial is 1. That's just something you're going to have to accept. So just know that, because if it comes up, 0 factorial is 1. We use the factorial operator to find the way n numbers of items can be arranged. It can also be used in a combination and permutation formulas. So let's look at an example where we use the factorial symbol and why that works. So let's say this 6 friends are going to a play, and they have 6 seats reserved, but no seat is tied to a specific person. How many different ways can the friends take their seats? And what I mean by that, if they all were given by letters, A, B, C, E, F, G, why I skipped D, I can't say. Those are the people that the way they could sit. They could also do A, B, C, F, E, G, where F and E are flipped, but nothing else. And we could say, okay, there's also, so we could start with B here or C here. There's a lot of different ways. And it turns out that the answer is 6 factorial, or 720 different ways that those friends could sit down together at the theater. This works because there are 6 ways to fill the first seat. So if this is my first seat and I approach it, any one of those 6 people could sit in it. But let's say A does take the seat. Well, then the next seat, there's 5 people left that need to sit down. And so there's 5 ways to fill that seat. But then now the first 2 people have been seated, and there's 4 ways or 4 people left to sit in the third seat. And then 3, and then 2, and finally the last person, G here, has no options. There's only 1 seat and 1 person. So that looks like a factorial. There were 6 choices, then 5, then 4, then 3, then 2, and then 1 for 720 possible ways for people to sit in a seat. So that's one way we can use that factorial symbol in solving a problem like that. The next video, I will talk about combinations and permutations. All right, have a fantastic day.